Welcome students. As you all know that lockdown is going on in our country, and moreover we don't know how long this lockdown period will continue. But you cannot lock down your studies. That's why we are trying to provide you some audio video classes so that you can continue your studies while staying at home. In this video I will discuss first chapter of your class 9 ICSE syllabus. There are basically three sections. First, number system and rational numbers. Second, irrational numbers. And third, thirds. Now I will discuss number system and rational numbers. Basically, this part is nothing but revision of your previous classes. Let me first discuss three important concepts of number systems: natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers. This part is basically revision of your previous classes. Let us revise it once again. We can define natural numbers as set of all counting numbers. If we denote this set by n, we can say that set n includes 1 to plus infinity, excluding any fractions or decimal points. For example, 1 by 4, that is 0.25, is not a natural number. Now, what is whole numbers? If we include 0 with the set of natural numbers, we will get set of whole numbers. If we denote set of whole numbers by W, it will include 0 to plus infinity, excluding any fractions or decimal points. Now come to the third point, that is integers. Integers are the set of all whole numbers plus the negative of natural numbers. If we denote set of integers by Z, it will include minus infinity to plus infinity, including 0, but excluding any fractions or decimal points. Let us try to understand the concepts of natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers with the help of a Venn diagram. First, consider the set of integers denoted by Z, starting from minus infinity to plus infinity. Now consider set of whole numbers. If we exclude all negative integers from Z, we will get set of whole numbers starting from 0 to plus infinity. Now, if we exclude 0 from the set of whole numbers, we will get set of natural numbers starting from 1 to plus infinity. Please note that we have not included fractions or decimal points in either of the number categories, whether it is natural number or whole numbers or integers. Now, I will discuss a very important concept, that is rational number. Let me first explain the definition of rational number. A rational number is a number which can be expressed in the form p by q, where both p and q are integers and the denominator q greater than 0. For example, 1 by 3 is a rational number because both 1 and 3 are integers and the denominator 3 greater than 0. Similarly, 0.75, which is equals to 75 by 100 and equals to 3 by 4, is also a rational number because 3 and 4 are integers and the denominator, that is 4, is greater than 0. Now, to understand rational number more precisely, we have to know what components of number systems are included in the set of rational numbers. If we denote the set of rational numbers by R, we can write R equals to all integers plus all terminating decimals plus all non-terminating but repeating decimals. So far, you may have noticed that we have not included any fraction or decimal expression either in natural numbers or in whole numbers or in integers. Now, in the set of rational numbers, we will include fractions or decimal expressions but with one restriction. Let me explain this. If we divide two integers, three cases may arise. Case 1, terminating decimals. For example, 1 by 4, we will get 0.25, which is a terminating decimal. Because this expression is terminated after 0.25. Case 2, non-terminating but repeating decimals. For example, if we divide 1 by 3, we will get 0.3333... This is a non-terminating decimal where digit 3 is repeating. Now come to case 3, non-terminating and non-repeating decimals. For example, if we divide 22 by 7, we will get a non-terminating and non-repeating decimal expression, which is equals to 3.141592 6, blah 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 blah. Here you can notice that no digit is repeating in a regular manner. In first two cases, that is case 1 and case 2, the expressions are rational numbers. But in third case, the expression is not a rational number, at is it has non-terminating and non-repeating decimal expressions. Now we will explain this with the help of a Venn diagram. We have already seen the Venn diagram of integers. Now if we add fractions either with terminating decimal expressions or non-terminating but repeating decimal expressions with the set of natural numbers n, we will get set of rational numbers r. That is, we can write r equals to integers plus terminating decimals plus non-terminating but repeating decimals. Now we will try to understand rational numbers with the help of three examples. Prove that 1, 0.57, 2, 0.3, where 3 is recurring, and 3, 0.27, where both the digits 2 and 7 are recurring, are rational numbers. Before solving these problems, we have to understand how we can prove a number a rational number. Recall the definition of rational number. According to the definition, a rational number is a number which can be expressed in the form p by q, where p and q are integers and q greater than 0. Now consider the first problem. The decimal expression, that is 0.57, is a terminating decimal. So just by removing the decimal point, that is by expressing it in the form 57 by 100, we can prove that it is a rational number, as both 57 and 100 are integers and the denominator, that is 100, is greater than 0. Now come to the second problem. Let x equals to 0.3 recurring. Now we can write x equals to 0.333 dot dot dot. Now multiply both the sides with 10, that is 10x equals to 3.333 dot dot dot. Now we can write 10x equals to 3 plus 0.333. Now we can write 10x equals to 3 plus x, because we have already assumed that 0.333 dot 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 is equals to x. Now we can write 9x equals to 3, or x equals to 1 by 3. That is, here we have proved that x, that is 0.3 recurring, is a rational number because 1 and 3 are integers and 3 greater than 0. Now come to the problem number 3. Here we are assuming that x equals to 0.27 recurring. Now we can write x equals to 0.2727 dot dot dot. Or we can write 100x equals to 27.2727 dot dot dot. Similarly, we can write 100x equals to 27 plus 0.2727. And we can write 100x equals to 27 by plus x, because we have assumed that 0.2727 dot 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 is equals to x. Therefore, we can write 99x equals to 27, or x equals to 27 by 9. Now 27 and 9 are integers and 99 greater than 0. Therefore, x equals to 0.27 recurring is a rational number. Now we will discuss two important properties of rational number. Number one, there are infinite number of rational numbers between two rational numbers. Number two, rational numbers satisfy the closure property under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Now let me discuss the first property, which is there are infinite numbers of rational numbers between two rational numbers with the help of an example. Suppose we want to find out four rational numbers between 1 by 3 and 2 by 3. First of all, we have to find out a multiplying factor. Here we want to find out four rational numbers between two fractions. Therefore, our multiplying factor will be 4 plus 1 equals to 5. After finding out the multiplying factor, we have to multiply both numerators and denominators of both the fractions, that is 1 by 3 and 2 by 3, with 5. First fraction, that is 1 by 3, will become 5 by 15 after the multiplication. And the second fraction, that is 2 by 3, will become 10 by 15 after the multiplication. Now, if you observe carefully, you can see that finding 4 rational numbers between 1 by 3 and 2 by 3 is same as finding 4 rational numbers between 5 by 15 and 10 by 15. Now we can get our desired 4 rational numbers just by adding 1 4 times with the numerators of 5 by 15, which are 6 by 15, 7 by 15, 8 by 15 and 9 by 15. Therefore, we can conclude that 4 rational numbers between 1 by 3 and 2 by 3 are 6 by 15, 7 by 15, 8 by 15 and 9 by 15. In this way, we can find infinite rational numbers between 1 by 3 and 2 by 3 just by adjusting the multiplying factor. Now consider another problem. Find 3 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 7. Here the problem is little bit different, because these two fractions 5 by 7 and 4 by 7 are not like fractions, as their denominators are different. Now to make them like fractions, we have to multiply both numerators and denominators of 3 by 5 with 7 and 4 by 7 with 5. As a result, both the fractions will be converted into like fractions, 21 by 35 and 20 by 35 respectively. Now you can solve this problem. I want to give you this problem as an assignment. In this section, we will discuss second property of rational number, which is rational numbers satisfy the closer property under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. It means if we add, subtract, multiply and divide two rational numbers, the result will always be a rational number. You can check this property with any two rational numbers. There are 6 assignments for you. Copy these assignments in a paper and try to solve these. But these 6 assignments are not enough for your exam preparation. You need to solve more assignments. If you need solutions of this assignment and many more problems along with their solutions, please WhatsApp your name, locality, school, board and class in the WhatsApp number 9903039009. In our second video, we will be discussing irrational numbers. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get early notification. Thank you.